Sephardic journey is a journey of a human spirit, a spirit which connects us all, regardless of natural or man-made borders, and mostly without regard to the passage of time.
Today we have new compositions based on all the Sephardic melodies. How did it all start?
In 1996, after 5.5 years war in former Yugoslavia, I was able to go back to my new country, Bosnia-Herzegovina. And my wife Eugenia came along with me for the first time to see the country and to meet my relatives. And in one of the visits, something extraordinarily happened. My great aunt, Razia Prcic, started speaking to Eugenia in Spanish. And Eugenia was surprised, while the rest of us were astonished. Nobody knew she spoke Spanish, so we were wondering how did she learn it. As the conversation progressed, we found out that Razia's mother converted from Judaism to Islam at the onset of the Second World War in order to avoid being prosecuted by the Nazi army. So they were the descendants of Sephardic Jews, people who were expelled from Spain in the 15th century and kept their music, kept their language, kept their traditions all these centuries. Razia's real name was Matilde. So finally she said to Eugenia, "With you, the circle is now complete. We are back to Spain."
With our curiosity piqued, over the next few years we came across interesting findings. Among them was the fact that my last names, Moliner Ferrer, are from Sephardic origin. In order to stay in Spain, the Sephardic Jews had to change their names. In the case of my ancestors, they took the names of their professions. Moliner means kneeler, and Ferrer means blacksmith. And when thinking about Spain, I was really thinking that the Sephardic music had to happen, because it was also in Teresa's family back in Bosnia, and it was in my family in Spain, so it just felt together like a puzzle. I had a dream long ago, and imagined music that Denis and I would play. Music based on these beautiful Sephardic melodies rooted in my native Spain more than 5 centuries ago. Today I'm very excited to have composers like Clarissa Sad, David Leisner, Carlo Rafael Rivera, Alan Thomas and Joe Williams writing wonderful music for this Sephardic journey. I held into the dream, like our ancestors did with their language, traditions and culture. But this music is now here to stay.